Summer has already begun here in El Paso. With that triple-digit heat sticking around all week, you might be looking for a way to cool down. KTSM 9 News reporter Carla Draxler is live in the Lower Valley to tell us about the city's cooling centers and other places to get that much-needed refreshment. But right now, Carla, it is windy out there.
Yes, Natasha, I don't really need a refreshment right now. However, I don't know if you can hear it. The ice cream man is here, and that means summer has started. This week, the rest of the week, we're going to be in the hundreds, so you're definitely going to need this refreshment here at the Splash Park. There's kids still around, even though it's really windy, but this is not the only place where you can get cooler here in El Paso. The city has also opened up 6 cooling centers, and I visited one of them off Alameda Avenue at the Valle Bajo Community Center. Now, fire department spokesperson tells me these cooling centers are free and open to everyone all week, and now with extended hours from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m., you can find a refreshing drink in there and even use the amenities like pool table, basketball court, and a computer room. But some chose to cool down at the city's water parks like Chapoteo of Giles Road. That opened for Memorial Day weekend, saying it is not only family friendly, but also doesn't leave a hole in your wallet.
I think it's beautiful. I love the slide, how they have it, and it doesn't go into the water, you know, so the kids can enjoy it if they don't know how to swim. They have the rock wall.
There's 2 sides. We can keep the kids on one side and then the bigger kids on the other side.
So it's
and
great.
No one's fighting.
And come out, have fun. It's not even expensive. It's a great time all around.
You can check out all the cooling centers and operating hours at our website, KTSM.com. And as far as the water parks go, if you visit after 3 p.m. every day, the tickets are half off. And you know what? I was actually going to go through one of these underneath the water, but considering this wind, I think I'll pass this time, but I'm pretty sure I'll want to be back here tomorrow. Back to you, Natasha.
All right, Carla, some good information. As you said, we're going to see triple digits throughout the week, so thank you so much for that, Carla. Well, some good news for nonprofits. Gator Tank is accepting applications to help small to medium-sized nonprofits grow. No, we're not talking about Shark Tank. It is Gator Tank. It's a program created by the Paso del Norte Community Foundation and Microsoft, providing funding opportunities and training for nonprofits. 6 eligible nonprofit organizations will be chosen by a review committee and announced on June 30th.
6 organizations are selected. They will be working with mentors through 6 different mentor sessions to really perfect their pitch.
The program will run from July